Alright guys, so I did my check-in. They gave me my stuff. They gave me door 14, but the thing is that door 14, it's not in this building, it's in the next door building. For some reason, it's over there, I don't know. It's supposed to be the same company and everything, it's just that it's just a different building. The load is in a different building. So I'm heading out right now of this building so I can go to the next building, and we'll go from there to see how long does it take. Hopefully it doesn't take too long. I have been to this place. I have loaded at this building before, and usually they don't do it pretty fast. So hopefully this time around it's not for so long, because I am trying to go. I'm not trying to be here another day. It is super hot. I've been here stopped already for 2 days. So hopefully it doesn't take them any longer. All right, ladies and gentlemen, so I got my paperwork. I am good to go. I'm actually heading out right now. I had to come back to the same location where I came the first time, because they sent me to the other stores, so I got the stuff, and now I came over here so I can get my paperwork. But everything's good. I got my stuff. I have to go get weighted, make sure that the weight is right. And once I'm done there, then if everything's okay, I'm good to go. If not, then I have to come back. Hopefully everything is good, which I do think is good, because I feel the truck, like, I know when my truck is heavy, I know what it's like. So we're good on that. So let's just continue the trip. Guys, we're gonna pull into the scale so I can weigh my truck and see how much I weigh, my total weight. Let's see what happens. I should be good. All right guys, so I'm heading out right now. I got my my weight check. I have 77,820 pounds. I had to move my axles to the front of the trailer. That means forward, right? Because I was over in my fifth wheel, 800 pounds. So I had to move it front, and then I had to, you know, I had to fix the weight in order to leave. So I did that. In the process of doing that, somehow I broke off one of the mud flaps. So there goes my shower, right? Now I have to take a shower a little up north. There was a line when I went back, there was a line now, so now I can't. I'm gonna go up a little up north, maybe in Louisiana or somewhere around there, and I'll take a shower there. Because there was a huge line, I don't have a lot of time in my hands. So with all that said, let's just continue the trip. Go to the right. It's night. I'm trying to get out of here quick. it is the next day. I got up now in the afternoon. I took a shower. I had lunch. I checked the truck. Everything was good. And I also re-weighted the truck. Because I saw that I weighed yesterday. And I had to fix my axle. And I did that. Like I said, I know my truck. I've been re-weighting. I did another adjustment so I can be 100% sure. My total weight is 78,320 pounds. And that is because I filled up my tank before I got here. So now in the fifth wheel, I have 32,540 pounds, which is completely legal, because for it not to be legal, you have to be over 34. And in the back, I have 33,360 pounds, which is completely illegal as well. It's gonna show you. I hope you guys can see it. They're good. Yesterday I had in the fifth wheel 34,800. Remember, before I left Texas, I moved my axles to the front. I fixed them, and then once you move, so I can explain the way that works. When you move your axles to the front, you're throwing weight on the back. And when you move your axles to the back, you're throwing weight on the front. That's how you more or less are able to manage to get the numbers even like I do. That's the only way you're gonna be able to do it. Sometimes it doesn't work at all, because sometimes they load the truck up bad. That no matter what you do, you're gonna be, you can be in the legal weight, where you can be, you can have more than 34,000 pounds in the axles. So if that's the case, you have to go back to the place, you have to reorganize the whole trailer. Okay, so like I said, I made it last night to Hammond, Louisiana. I got up this morning, or this afternoon, I had lunch, I took a shower, I weighed the truck, I checked the truck, everything's good, I am ready to go. So nothing, let's just continue the trip. I'm in the first rest area when you're going from west to east in Mississippi. Look at this beautiful sunset. I am here, yes, I have my hood open because I am checking the truck like I always do. I drove for like an hour and a half and I stopped to check it just because the hell of it. And look what I found. This is why I always check my truck a lot. Look what I found. Are you guys seeing what I'm seeing? So the bolt that holds the shock in place broke, and then that bent it up. It's always something, right? The little bolt right here. I don't know where the other part is at. It broke off. So, thank God that I have an extra bolt. I don't have an extra bolt the same size as that, but I have a bolt that I'm pretty sure it's going to work. All I have to do is use washers in the front and in the back. This is just a temporary fix till I get back down to Miami and get the whole thing fixed. What can I say? Things like this happen all the time. morning, guys. So obviously it is the next day. I made it to my location. I'm supposed to be unloading. I went through the guard booth already. They gave me my paperwork with some instructions on where is it that I have to take my paperwork. And that's exactly what I'm doing now. I am taking my paperwork to see if they give me a door, and hopefully I can get unloaded quick. I was actually able to find another load about 100 miles away from here, going to Pompano Beach, Florida. So we are gonna be picking up a load. Picking up a load going to Pompano Beach, Florida. We're picking up today, later today, and we are turning in tomorrow in the morning. And that should conclude the trip. That should conclude the trip. That's gonna be the rest of the trip. But anyhow, for now, let's just find our place. We're gonna have to turn in our paperwork so we get this load off the truck already. doors. Ladies and gentlemen, so I got unloaded a little while ago. I was just relaxing there for a bit. But anyhow, I'm leaving right now. I'm going to my pickup location. You guys saw in the previous clip, I told you that I was doing another pickup.
Continue on State Route 60.
Going to Pompano Beach. Up in Palmetto. I've never been there to pick up, actually. It's south of Tampa, and that load is going to Pompano Beach for tomorrow in the morning. So that should be fairly quick, should be fairly simple. We should be good to go. So all that said, let's just continue with the trip. So I'm at my location where I'm supposed to do the pickup. It's actually a little packed. Let's see how do I manage to turn around, because I don't know, it's full of trucks here, and it's not really that big. So we'll see. That the guy that was there, he left already. So now I can move. Sometimes I feel like you guys can see the same thing I see. We're looking good. Have to wait for traffic to not come anymore so I can pull forward in the middle of the street and then be able to line it up.
Thank you.
Alright guys, so currently here in Fort Pierce, Florida. Just finished washing the truck. I'm gonna have some dinner now and continue my trip. I am 90 miles away from my destination in Pompano. So let's get to it. Morning guys, so we are in the beautiful city of Pompano, Florida. It's a beautiful day out today. Hopefully it stays that way because I washed the truck last night, and hopefully my wash does not go to waste. So I did the check-in this morning already. I already turned in my paperwork, and they called me pretty fast to park in door number 4. So that's exactly what we are doing now. We're heading to door number 4 so we can pull this beast in and get unloaded. I wanted to share with you guys something. I wanted to share with you guys a comment that somebody wrote. And I tell you, man, some people just write things to write things, you know? I don't know, maybe some of you guys may have the same opinion. I don't know. I just thought it was funny. The guy said that I am not a driver. I'm just another YouTuber with a camera in my hands. I thought it was funny. He said I don't deserve a oh my god, I was cracking up. He said I don't deserve a Peterbilt. But I deserve a day cab bubble. Oh my god. It's all good. I respect everybody's opinions. It is what it is. I just thought it was really funny. It's okay, I understand. You don't have to like me. That's fine. I am not here to be liked, you know? It's alright. It's part of the game, you know? Some will like you, some will love you, some will hate you. It is what it is. That's just the way it is. And things will never be the same. Alright guys, so enough with the crap. I'm here in door number 4. There's trailers in front of me. The place is not small, but it's not big either. I think we should be good to manage to get her in. So we'll see. The good thing is I don't have nobody to my sides. So that's always a plus. So let me turn this camera good. Give you guys that good angle. Hopefully I can capture everything. Spicy with that trailer there in the middle. It's about to get really spicy with that trailer there. Put on my concentrating face. Much I was able to pull forward, but it wasn't a lot because I have a trailer in front of me. I don't know why I do that. straight to there. Time to park. See? And reality, it might look like there's a lot of spacing, but there's not. When you have a straight truck like this one, there is really not a lot of space. All right, guys, so I finally got my papers. Everything was good. Nothing else to say other than the trip is almost over. I'm going back to the yard now, so I'll catch you guys in like half an hour back at the yard. Let's go. All right, guys, so I got to the yard. I picked up all my stuff. I gave the trailer a little wash because it was dirty. And I almost forgot to close out the video for you guys. But before I do that, I want to take a quick second and thank you guys all for the love, for the support. You guys are killing it. Don't stop. That motivates me more and more to come up with ideas, to keep bringing out, you know, videos for you guys. You guys have any ideas of something that you guys think I should do? Comment down below. Let me know. And if it's in my possibilities, I will do it. So, with all that said, thank you so much for watching. Peace and keep on trucking.